はい。 那个荷兰的 Marshall alleged criminal。Yeah, in the US you can. There was this website with this entire database, pictures. But they're quite old. Years old. But it's the internet, you can find photos of everything. Don't know if I want to commit to this. Maybe the other one's better. Hey, show. I have a different one on my phone that I might want to draw. Maybe I want to draw this guy. Or maybe this guy. This guy is pretty cool. Thank you, Mersey. Or maybe I should continue this one, then not look at the reference anymore. I make a lot of layers and I merge them. Hey, Jess. Hey, Clevs, thanks. Bribing. That doesn't happen very often. I think you're like my tenth subscriber. Thanks, Marta Batista. I'll do that, JD. You'll never know when I will come, but I will come. Beat some motivation in you. So you better be drawing. Ah, boy. Oh, just to hear about my day. Look a little happier today. Oh man, I'm just tired. And I'm slightly in a bad mood, but not your fault. I like the eyes, I like the nose so far. Don't like anything the rest. Yeah, these are mug shots. I've collected over a couple of years. But I'm not sure if I want to keep it. But please be respectful of my reference. Bye-bye. What made me pick the faces? I kind of like the when the eyes are kind of in shadow, like when the face is turned a bit, and then you get this cast shadow, and then this little edge, and this little rectangular highlight. This one because of the scar. This one because of the skin color. And this one kind of same, like cool nose, I don't know. Very like shapey. Good structure, the shadow. Thanks, Jim. I'm kind of making my own version of it. Far, I don't super like it. Gotta draw something. Paper bag, Fiona apple. See you, man. And now we'll move into the 7 hours of hair rendering. Great content. It does, doesn't it? Means I don't know. I don't know. You're such an internet noob, Ellen. Okay, you're just a French internet person then. You probably know different abbreviations. This one. And this one. What's that? I was making a joke as like potato. I wonder how the guy got his scar. It doesn't look like a cleft lip. Could have been, but it looks more recent. Like his shape is like right. Could have been a cleft lip, but I'm not sure. Let's exaggerate that chin a bit. Like, get more square. Dream of Egbert. Yeah, you're not really supposed to play music that's copyrighted. When you do that, the VOD gets muted for the time you actually play the songs. Yeah, I think I tried to separate the sound. I have to check the VODs if it actually worked. Yeah, just because they, you know, they mute the VODs, but that's, you know, it still actually isn't allowed to do it live on stream. And I figure if I get a copyright strike, I'll stop this practice probably. And I haven't received any copyright strikes. When I upload the music to YouTube, like the VODs to YouTube, you know, YouTube just says you can't make any profit of these videos. And you have to agree to it. So Twitch mutes it, you know, like automatically. But YouTube also does a check, but they're actually more lenient than Twitch. They just say, you know, like a different company will make money off this. You can't make any income from your videos. It's fine for me because I don't make any money from them anyway. This is just like a radio on Spotify. I'm not completely responsible for this playlist. But, you know, it's based on whatever I listened before. What I did here in this thing, kind of going back to yeah, more contrasted state, and then I'm gonna try and rework it a bit. I ran into my ex Pixar buddy today. You should check him out. His name is This is his Instagram here. He's a storyboarder. He worked a couple of years for Pixar and now he's freelancing again from Belgium. He's got some great jokes on his Instagram. Get out. This dude is awesome. We all know who that is, right? Yeah, I knew he came back to Belgium, but like I hadn't talked to him since, and I was bringing my kid to school and suddenly I see this guy walking his dog and I'm like, I know this guy. So yeah, we had some coffee in his yard and stuff. Yeah, sure. I mean, he's a storyboarder, so it's not like you really gotta go through all his stuff, and you know, you'll see that this guy's he doesn't have that much on his Instagram. But if you go to his website, you can see. Oh, you can't see everything. That's too bad. He seems to have personal project. Right. We gotta keep going here. Hey, happy bash. Thanks for the subscription. Awesome. Pretty good. Trying to finish this sketch here. The references are like various mugshots I've collected on the internet. I got like a whole collection of it, of them. Cause I like, I don't know, I always like the lighting in them, like, and the, you know, the unique, the unique haircuts and fact that they're, you know, they don't look like perfectly dressed. And they're not like, they're not like the typical, you know, like funny pictures either. You know, they're just like people who are having a bad day. I mean, people are, of course, innocent until found guilty by a fair trial, you know, and mugshots are not, you know, they're not like already found guilty, you know, when their mugshot is taken. They actually might be innocent. Plus, like when you make a drawing based off them, it looks, it gives you something, you know, that you don't see a lot. Why my stuff might look a bit, you know, like the references you pick, it Yeah, it kind of fits better in, or it adds to my body of work in that way. You see a lot of people, they pick this, they draw from the same 20 photos on Pinterest, right? So you see a lot of the same stuff return. And then, you know, like, yeah, I've seen that, you know, girl. Like, there's this one that a lot of people have drawn. Like, I just kind of try to avoid that and use more obscure reference. Of course, now you're all seeing it. You know my secret now. But it's only 100 people. Can't do much with them. Cats, like, people can set like rewards, and then, you know, sometimes the streamer does something, you know, like, for example, you could set it to, if you have like 1 million channel points, I'll draw a cat or something. But I kind of not do that because I don't listen. I only have the one that says drink water. But I don't even do that one. Oh no, now I lost my. I clicked on something. Now I can't read the chat. There we go. I'll get some coffee maybe. Thank you, Kat. So just like to show you, this is like and why I have so many layers, right? So this is like a sort of work in progress sketchbook where I'm just testing my the pencil brush I made, right? So it's all these sketches from imagination and also some from reference. These are first 2 pages, then you get some more. This is, yeah, makes from like these four here are from imagination, and then this one's for these little statues are from reference. These two here are from reference, but I kind of try to draw them in my own style, and then all the other ones are from imagination. This is all from imagination, and these are, you know, these two are from reference. This one is based on, yeah, on this picture, of course, and then these two are from imagination.
And the hair is just like a big step darker than the rest of the face, so in this case it's quite, you just keep everything fairly dark. But basically with hair, if you know the highlights on the face, you can sort of figure out the highlights on the hair, because they would be hitting on the same places, then for example here on the right, the planes that have the same orientation will have the highlights as the planes on the face that have the highlights. So you can see here on the eye, for example, there's a highlight right there. Not sitting on top here, right? It's more like a front light. Hey, thanks, John. Thanks for the 3 months. So you can kind of faintly see you have like a hair lock here, and the highlight is like right there. Right, it's very faint, but it's right there. And here it's darker, and there's a gradient going from here to up to here, and then a gradient from this place to this place. Right. And then for the rest you can kind of see it here. There's a high, there's the locks going like that. And there's like a band that's a little bit lighter right there. And then this there's like a cut here. And then there's lighter area here. And there's the locks going like this. And then there's a little highlight here. But the hair I drew is not really following that rule, but might have to do that. I was just gonna do the, just fake it. Yeah, my sketch is not following the reference yet. Now it's getting closer to that. See, I'll do this one here. So it goes like that a bit. I have this lock like this. Then the highlight sitting on the lock right there. See that? That works, right? Yeah, if you have like a perfectly combed hair, it kind of forms like a helmet and has a very, very clear highlight. The more you mess it up, the more those planes are starting to, change angles. Like, and whenever the angle of a plane changes, the highlight is going to change. So yeah, those highlights are gonna start, shifting like that. That's how you kind of get that manga effect, right? So that, that zigzag line. But once you got like completely curly hair, those planes are like all over the place, and it's like one crazy mess. But you can now kind of see, like, starting to make sense the way, right? My highlights are more orderly than in the reference, because you're st I'm kind of stylizing it. So it's proved that I'm not talking out of my ass. I find references in a lot of places. Might be historical pictures, like resources, museums, like pictures from museums, of like a lot of public record stuff. So when I draw from it, it's allowed. There's no copyright thing. I'm not sure. I think mugshot, in this case that's mugshots, but I think mugshots are public record. But I don't doesn't may doesn't really mean they're copyright free, but if I'm ever gonna make a book, I don't want it to be like a copyright nightmare. Hey, Giorda, thank you for subscribing. That's great. Rancor soup. I know you from seeing around the coffee shop. Oh yeah? What's your actual name? Thanks, Jorda. You guys keep subscribing. I don't have to wait for our directors to email me anymore. I could just be a free agent. Hey, Rancor, what coffee shop? Thanks for the 2 months, Shmoovit. for this guy. No, I draw. No reason. I draw a few more characters. Ever try to get a Twitch partnership? Oh, I clicked the thingy, but they declined me. Not really thinking about like that. I don't really care about it yet. Oh yeah. Yeah, I can keep trying. They probably like to see some like you know, emotes and stuff. You know, like probably like to see people do the usual Twitch things. I usually don't spend that much time on that. I make like 30 bucks per month from Twitch. That's it.
Let's see if we can do a bit of Photoshop trickery. So just a little thing I did is just I like use the color, the place color function to make some of these strokes a bit darker. And then it kind of looks cool that to have like these like very bright spots show through. At least I think so. Yeah.
Yo, no mind. Boa. Dobra na te. Ne, komar. Nö, yok şu an var. Bir daha mı? Evet. Alright, I think this face is pretty much done. Maybe this, and it's a little bit highlight. So it's a bit more full value scale compared to this one. Mm-hmm. Won't have time to do another one. I kind of want to do this dude here as well. This was the reference. You see, it looks a bit, quite a bit different. Don't think there's any copyright issues anymore. Maybe the fact that it's recorded that I used is likeliness, maybe it's enough. But then what I do is I use this program to make a time lapse from it. Since I'm sharing you my secrets, I'll share another one. It opens. So, I recorded the process on a different window, like this. Right, so now I can just mute this. I go to the end, get the full image. I can scale it so it fits the video, like this. Probably better on us on a Instagram format. Yeah. Now it fits nicely. Then all I need to do is speed it up 100 times. Now I'll have a time lapse. Yeah, in Procreate it does it automatically, yeah, but Photoshop doesn't have that feature, so I have to do it this way. I don't like Procreate, so I have to do it again, because there's some cuts still, like, right. Where I like put a different window on it. So I have to like take those out as well. Mm-hmm. So with that thing, you can kind of expand your content for social media, and you can do two posts, one from the one of the face and then one for the process. Yeah, that's it for me. What I like about Photoshop is that I'm drawing, it's mostly that I like the drawing on the Cintiq. I like the size. I like the way I'm sitting. I like this chair. And if I use an iPad, then I gotta go like hunched over, draw on a small screen. I don't really like the feeling of the glass, the pencil on the glass. This the Cintiq has like some kind of etching. It's different on the newer iPads, not the one I have. Oh, I might give it another try. I like the fact that the Cintiq gets like warm, the screen is like, after a while it becomes warm, you can like warm your hands on it. Always get these dead fingers. Like, look how white become. I have to get the paper-like thing. That's a good idea. People like complain about overheating Cintiqs, but I don't think it overheats enough. Could be warmer. Okay. So, thank you all for watching. I'll read somebody. We rated this one yesterday. Looks good? Look. I'll try to find someone new. This person, cool. This one, John Silva. We've rated him before. I'm not gonna. Let's just take this one. See you.